Good morning, guys. Today we're going to look at factoring higher degree polynomials. We've already worked with factoring quadratics. Today we're going to look with cubics, quartics, fifth degree, sixth degree, and so on. Higher degree polynomials. First thing we're going to look at is quadratic form trinomials. So it's a polynomial. It's got three terms, and it's going to be laid out just like a quadratic. But instead of having x squared, x constant, we're going to have a degree, we're going to have half the degree, and then we're going to have a constant. When we have it in that form, it's going to break up just like we had in the quadratics into a pair of binomials of equivalent degrees. Well, that degree ends up being half of the original degree, just like x squared broke out into x to the first. If I had x to the fourth, it'd break x squared and x squared. If I had x to the tenth, it'd be x to the fifth and x to the fifth. Doesn't always work in every x to the tenth, but if it's an x to the tenth where we have x to the tenth, x to the fifth, and then a constant, then we can try it just like we do quadratics. So when it meets that format, or it looks like a quadratic trinomial, we can factor it the same way. So let's look at these examples we have here. Got 2x to the sixth plus 7x cubed plus 3. Got a degree, got half the degree, then I have a constant. So that's that quadratic form trinomial. So we're going to try it and see if we can get a pair of linear binomials. Sorry, a pair of, in this case, cubic binomials. So 2x to the 6th, just like before, is going to factor into my first two terms. So that's 2x cubed and x cubed. Remember, that degree in the center is a cube. That's why these have to break cubes and cubes, because they add to give that middle term. 3 is going to be 3 times 1. So if we try it out, we can do plus 3 and plus 1, last term into the last terms. Check it, 3x cubed plus 2x cubed gives us 5x cubed. Remember what we said before, if I need to change my number, because 7 and 5 don't match, I've got to go back and change my numbers. So in this case, I'm going to swap the numbers, because 3 and 1 is all the factors there are at 3. So let's just change the order, 1 and 3. So we check it, 1x cubed plus 6x cubed gives us the 7x cubed. Our number matches, our signs match, so this is the correct factorization. So remember, break up the first term into the first terms, last term into the last terms, and then check by recombining the inner and outer terms. Now in the second one, x to the fourth minus 16. This is like a quadratic. It's not a trinomial, but it is similar to a quadratic in that it's an even degree and it's a difference of two perfect squares. Remember, any even degree is a perfect, not any even degree, but a variable to an even degree, coefficient of 1, is going to be a perfect square. So we can treat x to the fourth, even though it's not a trinomial, we can treat x to the fourth minus 16 like we would a quadratic. This is just like a difference of two squares. Since x to the fourth is x squared times x squared, can be, it could be x cubed and x to the first. But since we're subtracting and 16 is also a perfect square, that's what tells us it's going to be a difference of two squares. So 16 is plus 4 and minus 4. If we check it, 4x squared minus 4x squared gives us no x's, which is what we have in the middle. So x squared plus 4, x squared minus 4, just like we're doing the difference of two squares. Now, when we do these higher degree polynomials, it may have multiple factorizations within each one. Just like if I take the number 30 and factor it into 6 and 5, 6 can break down again into 2 times 3. So that 2 times 3 times 5 is the final factorization, that prime factorization. This one right here could break down again, because here I have a quadratic binomial, a sum of two squares. We know those don't factor more, but here again I have a difference of two perfect squares. So the x squared plus 4 doesn't factor any further, it's finished. X squared minus 4, because it's a difference of two squares, x squared is x times x, 4 is plus 2 times minus 2. 2x minus 2x gives us no x's, and this is the final factorization for x to the 4th minus 16. So we use the same properties here as we did, or the same process as we did when we were factoring quadratics. We just need to make sure that once we've finished, once we have factored, whatever remains will not factor any further. If it does, we have to keep going until we have, in essence, a prime factorization. Every single factor is as broken down as it can get. Okay, the next type of factorization we're going to look at for higher degree polynomials is sum and difference of two cubes. Different from a difference of two squares, because this can be sum or difference. And that comes back to cubes. They're going to cancel a little differently because you've got that one more factor in there. And also because the property with a square, no matter what number I square, it always comes out positive. So a difference could be the only thing that cancels it. With cubes, if I cube a positive, it stays positive. If I cube a negative, it stays negative. So I have a little more flexibility in being able to cancel out that middle term. So sum or difference, two cubes, I like to always write it as a sum of cubes, something cubed plus something cubed. And that comes back to if this is a minus sign, I can just do plus a negative number cubed, because it'll hold that sign because it's an odd degree. When we recognize sum of two cubes and write it as sum of two cubes, I'm going to factor the first factor is going to be first base plus second base. No exponents, just whatever the first number cubed, the second number that is cubed. In the second set of parentheses, I've got the second base squared, and this comes from u cubed is going to break into u to the first times u to the second. Okay? And v cubed is v to the first times v to the second. And then where we bring up that extra little bit to cancel out those middle terms, then I'm going to have minus the product of the two. So, in general, first base plus second base, then the second factor, first base squared minus the product of the two plus the second base squared. Okay, so let's look at a few examples. If I've got x cubed plus 8, this is a sum of cubes because it's x cubed plus 2 cubed. So when I go in and factor this, I'm going to get first base plus second base, x plus 2, and first base squared minus the product of the two, so x and 2 plus the second base squared, 2 squared. Clean it up, x plus 2, x squared minus 2x plus 4. Now this will never, ever, ever factor. This quadratic here will never factor. It comes back to the fact that, remember, this looks very similar to that perfect square trinomial. Only difference is that perfect square trinomial had a 2 right here. Okay. The plus or minus doesn't really make a difference because that's a plus, so it's just going to be opposite signs. But if there was a 2 right here, then we know that it would factor. But since there's not a 2, we're obviously missing. We're one term short. Okay, so that's why we're not going to be able to factor these down. So you could try to factor, but it's never going to work out. So we just get x plus 2 times x squared minus 2x plus 4 as our final factorization. Let's clear this out of the way. Give some room to work. 27x cubed minus 125. This is a difference of 2 cubes, but I could rewrite it as a sum of 2 cubes. 27 is 3 cubed, x cubed is x cubed, plus negative 5 cubed, because negative 5 cubed is negative 125. Now that we've identified our bases as of the sum of 2 cubes, I can rewrite it as first base plus second base times first base squared minus the product of the two, so minus 3x times 5 plus the second base squared. Clean it up, 3x minus 5, 9x squared plus 15x plus 25. And that's the final factorization. It's a linear binomial, it won't break down anymore. And this is a quadratic trinomial that won't factor even if we try it. All right, let's look at number 3. X to the 6th minus 64. This is a sum of 2 cubes, because remember, if the exponent is a multiple of 3, then it's a power of 3. So that's actually x squared to the 3rd power plus negative 4 to the 3rd power. There's our sum of 2 cubes. So we're going to put them in the format here. First base plus second base, x squared plus negative 4, times first base squared minus the product of the two plus the second base squared. So squeeze that in. Now to clean it up, x squared minus 4, x to the 4th, plus 4x squared, plus 16. As we said many times, this will not factor. A quadratic trinomial, you can try and try and try, but you're never going to get a factorization. And the reason I said 4 is because we're missing the term there. 16 is 4 and 4. 4 and 4 is not going to add to give me 4. So there's no way. If that was a double right there, and that was 8, then we could do it. But it's not. It's never going to be, because this specific factorization is the only way to create a sum or difference of two cubes. Now this one can factor some more, because the first factor, x squared minus 4, ends up being a difference of two squares. X plus 2 times x minus 2. Then we have x to the 4th plus 4x squared plus 16. So this is the final factorization. I got a little sideways there at the bottom. But this is the final factorization of x to the 6th minus 64. So that's sum and difference of two cubes. Just like if you see sum and difference of squares, it's got that special factorization that we just really need to just remember how this thing is broken down. And you just plug it in and simplify it over. Evaluate it. The last type of factorization we're going to look at for higher degree polynomials is factor by grouping. We tend to use this when we have an even number of terms. If I had an odd number of terms, a lot of people will use this with quadratic trinomials, but you've got to then figure out how to break that middle term up to be able to group it, because we want two equal size groups. So I like to just use it when we do factor by, or when we've got four terms, I'll use factor by grouping, or six terms or so on. And all factor by grouping does is take a large polynomial and break it into small polynomials that I'm just going to do common factor repeatedly until I've completely factored this thing down. So if we look at this first example, 2x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x minus 9. So I'm going to group the first two terms together and the last two terms together. So on my first two terms, we want to identify the common factor. Well, both can divide by 2, both the constants can divide by, or coefficients can divide by 2, and both variables have at least a degree of 2. So 2x squared ends up being my common factor. Can divide by 2x squared, can divide by 2x squared. So I've got 2x squared, and what remains? 2x cubed divided by 2x squared is going to leave me just net. If I distribute it back, 2x squared times x is 2x cubed. Negative 6x squared, when we factor out the 2x squared, negative 6 divided by 2 is negative 3, and then x squared and x squared, it leaves me no x on the inside. So 2x squared times negative 3 was the negative 6x squared. So we group the first two together, pull out their common factor. Second two, we group them together, pull out their common factor. Greatest common factor is what we want. So they both can divide by 3. So if I pull out a positive 3, so that's plus 3, what remains? 3x divided by 3 is x. Negative 9 divided by 3 is negative 3. Now this is the part where I see, can I continue? Will factor by grouping work? If at this point, what I have left in the parentheses, my remaining binomial, which is what we have in this case, if it's identical, then we can continue on and factor by grouping will work. If it's not identical, then factor by grouping won't work, and we need to go on and try some other form of factoring or some other form of simplification. Depending on what the problem's asking. If it's solving, we'll come up with other strategies to solve when we can't factor. But in this case, the binomial is identical in both. As I said, you're just going to do factor by group or common factor again and again and again until we've completely simplified. So we now have a common factor of x minus 3 that I can pull out, and when I take the x minus 3 out of each one, when I divide it away, this was 2x squared minus 8 times x minus 3, so when I remove the x minus 3 as a factor, all I'm left with is 2x squared. Here, when I remove the x minus 3 as a factor, all I'm left with is plus 3. And we can put that back by doing distributive property. X minus 3 to 2x squared puts me back here. X minus 3 to 3 would have put me back here. So what we see is when I group the first two terms together and pull out their common factor, second two terms together, pull out their common factor, that common binomial that's now in the first, into the two halves of our expression, becomes one factor. The coefficients on those binomials, those first common factors, they become the second factor. So we just do common factor, common factor, common factor until we're down to something that resembles full factor. And we know we're finished because I have x to the first, no common factors left. Here I have x to the second, but it's not a difference of two squares. So this is the final factorization for this specific problem. Let's go on to number two. So we've got four terms, so let's check. First two terms together, do we have a common factor? Yes, it's x squared. So pull out the x squared, I'm left with x minus 2. X cubed, take away x squared, leaves x to the first. Negative 2x squared, take away the x squared, leaves negative 2. On the second one, I've got a common factor of 5, and that's going to leave me negative x plus 2. Well, as I said before, when I get to this point, if these are not identical, then I can't do common factor. Well, I can make these identical, because this is x plus 2, this is negative x. Sorry, this is x minus 2, this is negative x plus 2. So what could I have pulled out that would have made these two identical? I could have pulled out a negative 5. So as we talked about way back when we did the quadratics and we were doing common factor, if there's really a flexibility on common factor, whether it's positive or negative, and you pull out what you need to pull out. If you need this first one to be positive, I'm going to pull out whatever's going to make that first one positive. I need the second one to be negative, so I'm going to pull out what makes it negative. So as long as we're consistent with how we pull it out, you pull out what's necessary for that specific problem as far as positive or negative. Now we see that they have the same binomial, so we can now common factor that x minus 2, we pull it out. So x minus 2 is gone, and I'm left with x squared minus 5. And let's check what's left. First degree, no common factor, so it's factored all the way down. X squared minus 5. This is a difference of two terms. One of them's a quadratic, one's a perfect square, but the 5's not. If this had been like a 9 or something like that, then I could factor it further. And you can get a lot of things. This could end up being a cube, just depending on how these powers work out. So I could have a difference of two cubes that I would then have to factor on down. So just because you do one type of factoring doesn't mean you're automatically finished. You then check what remains to see if it can go any further. All right, so for higher degree polynomials, we can treat it like a quadratic if it's a difference of a square and an even degree. We can treat it like a quadratic if it's a quadratic form trinomial, degree, half the degree constant. Some indifference of cubes we have a strategy for. And then if I've got four terms or a large number of even terms, we can use this strategy for grouping. That's all the different ways we can factor higher degree polynomials. I'll see you in class tomorrow, guys.